Ciao friends! I want to show you how to read the numbers provided by Performance Analyzer in Power BI Desktop. In this example, we have a report with several visuals, and we already activated a session with Performance Analyzer capturing the information for the execution time of each of the visuals in the report. This information is displayed here in this pane, Performance Analyzer. And as you see, we have a relatively long list of visualizations. We have one row for each visual. Moreover, each of these visuals has an execution time of a few hundreds of milliseconds. When I open each of these visuals, I can see that there are several parts of the execution, DAX query, visual display, and other. And you can see that the number of other is around 700 milliseconds here, just at the beginning of the list. But if I scroll down, I can see that they have many visuals in this report. Moreover, if I go to the last items in the list, I can see that the execution time is mainly produced by the other section without having any time for the DAX query execution. So the first thing that I can imagine, if I have a long time in other, we have a problem with the number of visualizations we have in the report. So the first information I retrieve from the analysis of the Performance Analyzer data is that if I have many visuals, and many of these visuals have a high number in other, the problem I have is not I have a slow DAX query or a slow DAX measure. My biggest problem is that I have too many visuals here. What is the problem of this specific report? Well, we have here, for each of these numbers, we have a different custom visual. And each of these visuals require a different query. What could be a better strategy? Trying to reduce the number of visualizations, displaying the same number of information requires a different visualization. I could use a matrix, for example, so that instead of having this layout, I could have a sort of table or a matrix with different numbers, of course, with some more limitation in terms of layout, but basically, if I had a single visualization, I would have had a single DAX query, a single visual display, and a single waiting time for other. So the presence of too many visuals create problems from this point of view. Now, what about analyzing the other two information, the DAX query and the visual display? Well, we can analyze this data here because we have the ability to sort the list of the visuals in a descending or ascending way, choosing whether we want to display the visuals by action order, so in which order the visual has been executed within the report, or by DAX query, visual display, or total time. As you see, other is ignored here. But the problem is that if I display this data by DAX query, what you see that is that now the slowest visual is the first one, and the second one is the second slowest visualization by DAX query time. But because of this visualization that is hierarchical, sometimes it is hard to see what is the amount for the next one. You have to drill down every single visualization. So we can have a better way to understand the overall execution time if we export this data to an external file and we load this data with the load performance data feature in DAX Studio. I already did this, so we can see here that the long list of visualizations we have is represented here in a tabular format where I have a column with all the timing for the DAX query execution and the timing for the rendering of the visual. So for every visual, this is what is happening. First, the query is prepared and sent to the database engine that retrieves the data from the in-memory database and generates a list of rows that contains the numbers that we want to display in the visualization. Then the visual gets this list of data and actually creates an image on the screen. It could be a map, it could be a chart, it could be just a table that represent the numbers that have been retrieved by the DAX query. So this process has two different timing. Query millisecond, which is the DAX query, is the time that we needed to wait in order to retrieve the data from the database. Render millisecond is the time required to actually create the bitmap or the image that you see on screen. Now, I'm using now the same sort order that we have seen initially in Power BI Desktop, but using DAX Studio, I can sort this list, for example, by the query in milliseconds. Now, this is ascending, so the quickest query is the first one here, and if I click again, I can see that the slowest query in the entire report is this matrix. So I can see that if I want to optimize the time spent for the DAX code, which is something I can change in my model by changing the DAX code, I have to focus on the content of this visualization. The filters, the measures, I have to analyze what the DAX is doing and try to optimize it. And we needed to do the analysis of a query plan in DAX, which is the topic for another video. The second column that we see here is the rendering time. And the rendering time is the time spent to actually display the visual. And as you see, now in this case, we have a time that is 70 milliseconds, 70 milliseconds, and so on, which is not actually a big time. But if you consider the number of visualizations we have in the report, this time is multiplied by probably 50 or something like that. So it starts to be a significant number in terms of something that can be perceived by the user in terms of seconds. So what could we do at this point? Well, just looking for a visual that instead of spending 70 milliseconds, spends for the same operation maybe 20 or 10 milliseconds could be better. And in this specific case, one of the problems could be that instead of using a custom visual, I could use a native visual. Now, custom visuals are very good. They provide me a lot of flexibility, but they have a bigger cost. So the rendering time of a custom visual is usually more expensive than a native one. So the suggestion is to try to reduce the number of custom visuals you have in a report. You can afford 1, 2, 10, maybe not 50, like in this case. And if I go back to DAX Studio, we can see that once we analyze these two columns, we can figure out what could be the maximum optimization we could have by reducing the number of visuals, by finding a faster visual, and finding a faster visual is something that you can analyze in detail looking at these numbers, or simply identify the slowest DAX query, like I'm doing now, so I sort by the query millisecond of the matrix in this case. If you double click on this query, you can retrieve the query here, and then you can start running the query within DAX Studio, getting the query plan, server timings, and starting an optimization session that is the topic for other videos. Enjoy DAX!